Live gigs are coming back. This is brilliant, but it means that I need to get back on it and start learning songs so that I can perform them live in front of lovely, lovely people. What I'm going to do is I'm going to walk you through the process of how I learn a song, and hopefully this will give you some things to think about, okay? We're going to look at the artist Sam Fender and the song Will We Talk, and we'll get started right about now. Step number one for me is, doi, listen to the song. You'd be surprised how many people pick their instrument up straight away and don't actually take the time to listen to the song and think of what's going on. Listen for the instruments, listen for the chords, the harmony, all of that. So let's have a quick listen now, shall we? Here we go. Beautiful. Oh, mad tune. I absolutely love this song as well, this whole album. If you don't know Sam Fender, go and check it out. But let's listen. Okay, drums. Yep. Driving guitar, love it. Ah, such a good voice as well. Beautiful. Bruce Springsteen meets the Killers, loving it. So, be as familiar with the song as possible. The more familiar you are with the song, the more you know the song inside and out, the better you'll be able to perform it. So, listen to the song as many times. Pop it on in the car, pop it on when you're walking to work, whatever, so that you've got the song in your head, okay? Step two, write everything down. Lyrics, chords, the whole shebang. Learn as much of it as you can by ear, so just listening to it. So, for example, let's go back to the beginning of this song. And what you're going to do is we're going to find the home note. So we're going to find the note that you can hum throughout the song. And this will most likely, 9 times out of 10, be the key of the song, okay? Okay, there we go, straight away. Okay, so that is the note. That is going to work through everything. So we need to find that on the old ukulele, okay? So the way I do this is I just basically randomly put my finger until I find it. So, nope, that's too high. There we go. So C sharp or D flat is the key of this song. Now we need to work out if it's major or minor. The way we're going to do that is by looking for the third note in the scale. Because if it's a major third, it'll have that happy uplifting sound. And if it's a minor third, it'll have that sad sound. Okay, so in essence, let's just listen to it and see if it sounds happy or sad. Sounds pretty upbeat, sounds pretty happy. Let's find that third note. Yeah, okay, so we are in D flat major. Excellent, wicked. So that is our key of the song. So I get it, get my lovely trusty notebook here, and I'll write it down, okay? Then we need to obviously continue listening and work out those chords, okay? So we start with... Okay, so let's just listen through it again. And when I'm listening here, I'm listening to the bass because the bass always normally underlines the harmony, okay? So we're starting with a D flat major. Then we're moving down to an A flat major. And then down again to a G flat major. And then we're returning that to a D flat. Now, these are chords from the D flat major scale. And what you can do is you can just Google it. So if I Googled chords in the D flat major scale, I would find all the chords I need, and I've got... These are chords number 1, number 4, and number 5. And the order that we're going to play it in is in that verse, it's going to be a bar of chord number 1, D flat. Then we go to the 5, then we go down to the 4, and then we return to the 1. And that's that verse. There's the 5, just all downstrokes as well. da, 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 da. Okay, good. So we've got those chords there. Okay, now let's keep on listening. Let's have a look at that chorus now. Nice. And then we're going to go home. Yes, nice. Excellent. We're going from chord 4 to chord 5 three times. So that's 4, 5 times 3. And then we go back to 1. Excellent. So now we've got the verse and the chorus. So like with most songs, we have most likely going to just repeat those verse to chorus ideas. Let's have a little listen to that second verse. Ah, okay. We've got some strings and we've got a xylophone. Okay, so we've added a little extra lovely layer here, so we'll come back to that in a little bit. But chords are the same. Brilliant, brilliant, fantastic, awesome. So I'm going to skip a little bit to that middle eight part then. Okay. So we've got a B flat and a B flat minor because it's the sixth chord. Now again, if you're not sure about the chords in the scale, just give it a Google. I love Google, it's great. So we start with a six. Now what we're doing, so quite a common songwriting thing here, we're just working our way down. So we go from the sixth B flat to the five A flat to the four to the one, and then I imagine we're going to go back into the chorus because I like the song and I know it quite well. So then we'll go back into 4, 5. So that middle eight is going to be 6, 5, 4, 1. She said, if you dance with me, go. Nice. Okay. Then I'm going to do exactly the same for the lyrics. So again, I pop the old instrument down, I pick up my pen, and I start listening to those lyrics. And it's great. This activates something in your brain called the reticular activating system, which is basically all the stuff that goes on in your brain that helps you commit stuff to memory and to your long-term memory. So if you ever had difficulty learning lyrics, write them out by hand. The longer you do it, the easier it becomes. I can write lyrics out once or twice and then have them memorized, okay? So I won't take you through the whole process on this video, but rest assured that I will do it. So let's have a little listen. Okay, Blue Monday. Okay, pause. So we've got Blue Monday blaring loudly out the speakers. There you go, lovely scruffy handwriting. Okay, and this is the entire process you go through the song. And this is really a lot easier if you do step one and you listen in a lot more detail. So the more you listen, the more you will internalize those lyrics generally. Step three, and this is an optional step and it depends on your singing voice, okay? So if you want to do it in its original key, wicked, then you can skip to step four. However, if you're like me and your singing voice is actually at a different level to this, so Sam Fender has a really lovely high voice. Me, I'm really bassy. I couldn't sing this in its original key. I'm like, Blue Monday, very loudly at the speaker. Like, it's really quite high for me. It's on my break, especially in that chorus, you know. If you dance with me, darling. It doesn't sound good. So we need to look at transposing this into a different key. So in the last step, I was talking about those different numbers. So, you know, had chord 1, chord 4, chord 5. By putting a numerical value to a chord, whether it's 1, 4, 5, etc., this makes transposing it into a different key a lot easier. So, for example, this song is in, the original key is D flat major. Here you go. Ooh, beautiful. And then each of those chords, you put a number to. Now, to put this in a different key, all you have to do is choose another key and then find the related chords to the related numbers. Now, choosing a different key is just about experimenting, either going higher or lower, depending on your singing voice. So it takes a bit of time, because obviously you need to let your ears get used to the next key, but Blue Monday, that is far too high for me. So I'm going to take it down half a step to C. Blue Monday. Now I'm still straining quite a lot in that. So I'm going to keep taking it down. So from D, I'm going to go to B. Blue Monday. Okay, now the verse sounds quite nice there. Blue Monday. Okay, let's think about the chorus. If you dance with me, it's still pretty high for me. So basically keep on going. So I think, I know I sing well in the key of A major. So Blue Monday, blaring loudly out the speaker, fluorescent liquid in his beaker, another night that gone too far. Sounds pretty good in the verse. Let's try the chorus. She said, if you dance with me, darling, if you take me home. Now, still a bit high in the chorus, but with a decent warm-up and a bit of gusto, because this song, you have to give it a bit of a yell, I think it's going to work. So I know that it's going to be good in A. Okay, so then step four. We need to start thinking about sound and arrangement. So thinking about how I want this song to actually sound. Now, I could just play it with bog standard chords, A major, E major, D major. But if we listen to the song, there's a somewhat kind of folky kind of feel. I think they're not playing, I think they're probably playing bar chords, maybe even just power chords. They're taking away a lot of the different notes and they're kind of simplifying it so that it's a bit more like a. So let's just have a quick listen and let's just hear what it got. So back into C sharp though, because this is the original tune, so. So we got there. Duh, duh. So we got the first and the fifth note in that C, so. So again, a quite simple harmony. We don't have the additional third in there that makes it super major. Okay, so I want to keep it quite simple. So I could do an as a, but again, I'm thinking about this in relation to A. So, okay, so then. I still got that third in there. So what I think I'm actually going to do is I'm going to switch this up and I'm going to take my baritone ukulele out and see if I can get that kind of open tuning folky sound with that. Okay, let's have a look at that, shall we? And I've had a little bit of a play with some ideas and I've got this. So remember, I'm using the chords A, E and D for a majority of the song, which is going to be chords 1, 4 and 5. And then we've also got the sixth, which is a F sharp minor. So what I've done is I've voiced them slightly differently so that I've got this really open kind of feel. I've taken up most of the thirds. So, a major chord is 1, 3 and 5. And I've just sort of done first and fifth. So that A chord, really big, open, quite rocky. Then the E chord, again, the first and the fifth octave, and then I've got that open string, and that gives it a really open, almost kind of folky, but big stadium rock kind of vibe. And then the D, I've done the same thing. I've got that open string, that open E string, which gives us that lovely D sus 2 sound. So it kind of comes together like this. If you dance with me, darling, if you take me home, will we talk in the morning? this step here, the step four, is really about, again, finding the sound. I've also got my Helix LT set up here. So all of my effects come in. And I've put together the sounds I want for this particular song. So I'm starting with this somewhat kind of overdriven sound. And what I think I'm going to do with this is I'm going to put it with a loop station and then put this in as a loop for the entire song, just to give it some nice sort of meat to it. So I've got some distortion, I've got some delay, and I've got some reverb, just to give a bit of oosh. Then I've got my sort of main sound for most of the song, which is just a bit more of an acoustic sound, because I want to still have that ukulele acoustic, a bit of a folky kind of sound. Just big and beefy. Still a little bit of reverb on there to just give it that lovely big hoofy feeling. And that's going to be most of the sound for the verses. And then what I want to do is in the choruses, I want to take it up a notch, okay? So then I've got another preset here for the choruses. So I've put some distortion back on. Not too much distortion, keeping it quite gentle, but just to give it a bit of oomph, a bit of zhuzh. And what I've also got is a very small amount of low octave in there. It's very, very subtle. It's very low. But what it does is it just gives it a bit more boost and a bit more lift, so that when we go into the chorus, really getting it going there. And I think that's really quite tasty. And then finally, I've just got the big boshy noise for like the middle eight and the end. So it's that same chorus sound, but I've put a bit of a swelling delay on it, just to give it, again, a bit more oomph. So that's, will we talk in the morning? And then, oh, it's big, it's epic, it's great. Final step then is practice. Practice, 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 practice. Practice along to the original track, or practice your new transposed version. So now that I've had a go with these ideas and I've got this song internalized and I'm happy with it, what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up my loop station and I'm just going to play around with some loops and practice and then see how I get on from there. All right? Beautiful. Here we go. Much for watching, folks. Now if you want to see the full version of this video and the audio download, you can do so by following the links to my Patreon page down below. You can get exclusive access to all of my YouTube audio, take part in polls to decide what video I make next, and if you're an absolutely badass mother plucker, you can get some one-on-one lessons with me over the internet. All right, guys, these videos are brought to you with the support of my patrons. I couldn't do what I do without you guys, so please consider taking a trip over there and checking it out. I'm Ukulele Simon. I will see you next time.